In this video lecture, we are going to learn about the recursion then. What I have seen that the many students face the problem when you go for the definition of the recursion. Students say that the recursion is the one function that call itself. That will be enough. No. Actually, when you go for the definition of the recursion, you can say that the function call itself and the potential call of the function to perform the specific tasks, and it can be end after meeting the base condition of the function. That is the your recursion. Here you can see the example. So here we have called the fact, yeah, integer y, and we have written the condition if x equal to 0, y will be there, otherwise y will be x into the fact n minus 1. So here what we are doing, that this fact is calling the itself here. So it is a direct call here. So you can see that suppose a is the function and a is call itself, just like here I can say that this is a fact. Fact is here, you can calling the itself. So I can say this is the your direct call, so it is a itself. But the potential call of the function, you can see here, suppose a calling to b, b calling to the c, and then again c calling to the a. So indirect, what you can say that a is calling to the itself there. So that is the correct definition of the recursion: a function call itself and potential call of the function to perform the specific task, and it can be end after meeting the base condition. Base condition means when this will be end, when x equal to 0, that will be the end, perform the your specific task and then return. I will show it later on. So what we can say that in case of the function, two things are common here. One is the base case and the second one is the your recursive case. The base case means the case where which will be satisfied by the recursion, and after the satisfying, it will be the end here. So in this function, you can see here, so when you want to calculate the factorial of the any number, how you can calculate it? So you know that the if x equal to 0, it will be return the y equal to 1. That is known as the your base case here. Means this is your stopping criteria of the your recursive function. And the recursive case means the function will call itself to perform the specific task. So here you can see that here fact n minus 1, again it will become until and unless value of n equal to become the 0. If it is the 0, so it will be the your case will be there. So here you can see that we not write the x, this is the x is there, x minus 1, all right, not the n minus 1. Now, so these are two cases we have to satisfy in the case of the recursion. Otherwise, it is the very hard to perform. If the base case is not present in any recursion, so you can say that the your program may be the your infinite loop, because you are calling itself repeatedly and we are not stopping there. Now you can see example. Suppose I have given the x equal to 5. According to this function, 5 will become here, so it will be check if x equal to 0. No, this condition will be not satisfied because x equal to 5. So it go to the else part. Else part means x is the 5 here, and we have to calculate the factorial of this one like this. The 4 will become again this part. Check, this is 0. No, again it will become this part. So it become the 4 into the factorial of the 3. In case of third iteration, again it become the 3 into factorial 2. In you can see here, in the fourth case, it again become the your factorial or 2 into the factorial 1. In the last case, it become the your 1 into factorial 0. So 0 is the, you can say that the 1 will be the 1 into 1 will be the 1 there. All right. So here you can say this base case will be satisfied, because in the last case, when the x equal to 1, it become the 0. So 0 will become x equal to 0, base case is 1. So here you can see that this 1 factorial 1 be 0 is the 1. So 1 into the 1, how it solve the problem? So this 1 will be put into the this part. You can see here, to 2 into 1 will be there. So we have calculated the value of the this factorial 2. This factorial 2 value will be put it here. Again, in this case, we have calculated factorial 3 value. Can say this whole part, this will be putted here. In this case, we have calculated the value of the 4, factorial 4. So it will be the, you can say this is a factorial 4 value, and this will be put to the this part. So what is the this one result is the 120. The factorial calculate in this way, because when you pass the any value, this will be recursive, and the value will be less by less. When the base case will be match, then it will be return the value, and based on that value we have to calculate it. Here we have seen that first 5 is there, we have to know, want to know value of factorial 4. 4 will be there, I want to know value of factorial 3. 3 is there, I want to know the value of factorial 2. 2 is there, I want to know the value of factorial 1. 1 is there, I want to know the factorial value 0. When 0 satisfy here, 1 will be returned. So 1 will be come here, so 1 into 1, it become the 1. This value will be put here. So this value will be calculated. This value will put here. I can say this value will be calculated. This value will be put here. So I can say this value will be the calculated. And this value will be put here. So I can say this value will be calculated. And after the calculation, this will be returned to the here and you can print. So I hope that we can understand it. Thank you.